but I've always liked to build things. And so I really like building sails.
I'm Mark Reynolds, and I'm in charge of Inshore One Design at Quantum. My loft is in San Diego, where we have been located for, I don't know. I guess it must be somewhere around 35 years or maybe a couple more. I started in sailmaking. Actually, I was planning on right out of school, but I did an Olympic campaign in the Flying Dutchman. And so started in 1980 and was at North Sails for 2 years and then started my own loft here in San Diego with Sobsted Sailmakers. And soon after, Sobsted was joined by most of the guys, or a big chunk of the guys now, that are with Quantum. And we all left in the 90s. I came in the late 90s and have been with Quantum doing primarily One Design sales ever since. So I'm in charge of Inshore One Design, which kind of makes sense because that's what I've been doing pretty much from the beginning, doing small boat, small One Design sales here in San Diego. We primarily had focused on Snipe and Star, but did a lot of local classes and national classes, Lightning and Thistle and Flying Scott and some classes, but really got more involved over the last 3 to 4 years with Quantum, taking on, focusing more on other One Design classes that are primarily national, but also international. We've been doing a lot of R&D with J70, and now with some of the scow classes, we even did an ice boat sale, a DN sale last winter. And so really, I think there's well over 100 different One Design classes. So obviously we don't make sales for all of them, but we try to make sales for a good percentage of them. And, I would say, I think we probably make sales for might be 60 or 70 different One Design classes. All in all, some of those not made here in San Diego, but made at our other lofts. I've always been pretty partial to the Star boat. My father sailed Stars. In fact, he won the Star Worlds crewing for Dennis Connor back in 1971, which I was a kid out there on the water watching. And it really is part of San Diego and part of San Diego Yacht Club, because before Dennis, we had Malin Burnham and Lowell North and Jerry Driscoll, Bill Wagenforth. We had, I think our club now, along with Eric Doyle and Vince Brune and George Szabo and Paul Caird, who was a member of our fleet when he won the Worlds, I think we have Joe Lonergan, well over 15 world championships won by San Diego Yacht Club in the Star boat. So it was really just a natural to focus on that for me. And so when I got into sailmaking, trying to make a better Star sail was my main focus. And that was the sport that I was involved with. The class I was involved with was sailing, which took me to the Olympics 4 times as an athlete and 3 times as a coach. In the One Design sales, our models are pretty limited. So you could optimize the sail for light air, you can optimize it for heavy air. But when you go out One Design sailing, generally the condition, you don't know exactly what it's going to be. And in a lot of classes, you're only allowed one main, one jib, one spinnaker. So generally, we try to design the sails so they have a good wide range. But depending on where somebody lives and primarily sails, if you always sail on a off San Diego, for instance, in the Pacific Ocean, where you're going to have chop and light air, it probably makes sense to optimize the sails a little bit. Make them a little bit fuller than you would. That could also be the case if you sail light or you sail heavy. So a Snipe would be a good example there. If it was a really light team, they might want a slightly flatter sail than a heavy team. So that's probably the first thing we work with a customer when they call is, what are your sailing conditions? What weight do you sail at? And, we then suggest what model would suit their situation. Boy, that's a tough one. My first tip would be if I was on the boat with the customers, and particularly if we're going out, would probably be racing if I'm going out with them, is let's have fun. Bottom line, I'm not doing it for money. That is a good question. The traditionally, the upwind has really been the focus, you know, and I'm kind of referring to my experience in the stars for the most part. But, you know, we used to, all the training we would do is primarily sail testing going upwind. Now, kind of makes sense because the sail is probably, the sails are, especially in a boat that doesn't have a spinnaker, the sails are a little more critical upwind than they are downwind. You can design a sail that might help you a little bit downwind, but primarily design the sails for upwind. So most of my sailing's been upwind. But the sport really over the years, and starting when I probably transitioned from the laser to the star, the sport has really, the expertise in downwind sailing has really been advanced. And so when I first got in from the laser, I was really fast downwind. And it's actually a pretty easy place to pass. Going upwind is a little bit harder, especially if somebody's taking your wind or whatever. Coming from behind is always a little easier. So traditionally, I always focus on upwind. But in the later part of my career, I've focused a lot more on developing a good downwind technique. As the fin sailors have come into the class, they've moved it to another level. It's gotten a lot more athletic. But being able to, in any boat, and it's a lot harder as you get into a bigger boat, but any boat, the weight and your positioning in the boat going downwind really facilitates the steering. And being able to heel the boat to windward or to leeward to go up or to go down a wave really makes a big difference. So developing that technique. In the old days, we used to wait, like when my dad crewed for me, he would pop open a beer and maybe even have a sandwich on the downwind leg. Today, you might want to do that at the finish of the upwind leg so you can work hard going downwind. I've always been an inshore sailor. For some reason, even when I was a kid, you know, there was offshore going on at our yacht club, but the kids at our club didn't really gravitate towards that at all like it does in a lot of places. So I really never got much experience in big boats, and the little bit that I did have was not all that enjoyable. I'd much rather race, you know, two or three races during the day, come in, take a shower and have a beer at the bar rather than go 24 hours or more, which actually I've done a little bit. I did do one leg of the Whitbread or actually I think it was already the Volvo at that point, but it's a little bit different. It's more like kind of like combining camping out with sailboat racing. I think in the old days it was more like camping out. Now it's a lot more like an inshore race, but I enjoy inshore racing a little bit more. And my favorite color is blue. Can't really tell you why. I guess it was something I picked as a kid and it just stuck. I got my blue buff on. My favorite part about my job, I would say, is probably the actual building of a sail. I don't get to do it as much. Actually, I'm doing a little bit more lately as we're doing more R&D, but actually getting out there and cutting a sail and sticking the sail together. That's one reason I went into sail making. The main reason was I wanted to continue to sail as much as possible, and sail making was the way to do that, particularly when I joined, when I was initially racing, doing Olympic sailing. But I've always liked to build things. And so I really like building sails. Today, getting in touch with somebody has kind of gotten in some ways more complicated. I mean, in the old days, it was we'd see each other at a regatta and we're talking the phone, and then faxes came along and that made it sometimes a little easier, especially with different language barriers. But today with Facebook messages and Skype and Instagram direct messaging, and there's a lot of ways, but I try to stay on top of all of them. So if I get a Facebook message, I hopefully catch that. I kind of prefer email for the most part because it's all in one place and I can answer it any time of the day, which with time zones, we do a lot of business with Europe and sometimes Australia. It's that's tends to be an easy way of doing it, but Skype, whatever. I've got them all, I think. Probably not all.